admire about Janet is, you know, occasionally, I think I even did this to her face from time to time, I'd call her a policy wonk. She loved this stuff, and she was good at it, and she took the time to do it, because I don't really like this binder. Janet loves her binders. And on these really important technical things that people weigh in and affect our lives, our pocketbooks, and most people don't even know about these other agencies. Janet did a really fine job, and she ought to be commended for that, because that really was above and beyond. And as Jill said, yeah, there's a stipend, but I guarantee you, in terms of Janet, she was subsidizing the public. And the other thing is, you know, she has been just a real class act since November. And, you know, I think my favorite story will be I ran into Janet as she was moving out of her office last night, and I was preoccupied with car trouble. I publicly acknowledge and apologize I didn't offer to help you carry boxes to her. And I thought to my, yeah, I know, really, I thought about it. And I said, what a jerk. I could have at least helped you, but I was preoccupied. But Janet says to me, listen, I got this email and this call, and it was on a particular situation, and I just looked at her and I go, right to the end. She was thinking about District 3 and solving a problem. Now, where I gotta tell you, that impresses the heck out of me, right to the end. So you did an awfully, you ought to be proud of that, and I'm certainly, I just think very, very classy stuff. So thank you for that. I'm going to let Janet and Steve talk, but I've occasionally used this line before. Hopefully I'll get through it, but my favorite line in literature is from the book The Brothers Karamazov, where the main character, after they've been through a shared experience, says, he looks at the group of folks and says, you know, you must know that there's nothing higher and more useful in life than some good memory. We've had a good memory. So thank you. So with that, before we go to closed session for one last time and talk about stuff you can know nothing about, if Councilmember Villegas and Councilmember Barnes have a comment to our vast viewing audience, I will start to my right, ladies first.
Well, wow. I have to focus or I won't get through it.
I can kick it to Steve.
I can first.
You want me to go to Steve? You promise you'll be composed and ready to go? You promised. You're all right. Because I hate to see Villegas cry. I hope he's ready. All right. He won't. So, okay.
Well, I don't know if you're going to see that happen there. But first, thank you to my colleagues for the kind comments that you stated there. It diddle right back at you. That I think that's what I'm probably going to miss the most, is working with you. And the city employees, you guys have been great. I developed great relationships with you guys. The fire department, you've just been so wonderful. You were so supportive in my campaign, and I'll never forget you. Relationships were really strengthened there. Police department, I don't know why our relationship declined. I'm still waiting to hear from that, but I've always been supportive of you guys, and I'll always still be supportive, but for whatever reason, there was a loss of support there. And, you know, my son's a deputy sheriff, and, you know, I always have that support. You know, public safety was my life. Nearly lost my life my first year when I got stabbed in the neck by an inmate at the jail when I worked there. And thinking this is not the way it's supposed to be. You know, I think you're going to lose your life your first year. And unless you've been a cop, you don't know what it is to be one. You don't go to school, you don't go to an academy, and I think you know what it is to be one until you've served the lines out there. So that's why I have tremendous respect for the fire department and the police department. When I retired, I guess you are going to see it.
Cheers.
When I retired 3.5 years ago, I was thankful for coming out with my health. you know, 30 years in law enforcement, that's tough. You know, I was a detective for 22 years, and I worked narcotics, homicides, sat across the table from, thank you, gangbangers that just shot somebody, and I'm sitting there for hours trying to squeeze a confession, which I successfully did several times. That's why I was very good at what I did. And I understand this mentality of what's going on in our city. And I felt I could have did more. I know it's probably one of the regrets that I have that I didn't do more. Probably being more involved in our gang problem. I was waiting to be asked. Never really happened. But the expertise was there, and it'll still be there. But I'm not going anywhere. No regrets. You know, I'm still going to continue to do the things that I did that got me elected the first time. Less than 2 months, I'll start my 25th year coaching track and field here at Salinas High, working directly with kids. And those are always the fun times. People ask me, what am I going to do with my time? I said, well, coaching. I love doing that. I've always worked it for all those years. And you see kids, you know, they're in trouble, and you keep them on the right path. And I've always used athletics, and it's worked. And they appreciate the times that we, or the time and the hours that we put in for their, for their health, really. Keeping them on the right path, and they remember and they appreciate that. And then 4 or 5 years later, you get an invitation in the mail to attend their wedding. They don't forget you, and that's what's really important. That's why I never really wanted to move up the ranks in police work. You know, I got promoted once when I went from a deputy sheriff to a deputy investigator, and that was enough, because I always wanted to continue to work with our youth in our city here. But I'll continue to do that. Politics, it can be very cruel, as it was, you know, well, for Jenna and I. You know, you do the good work, and then people don't see the good work that you do, and yet they find a reason not to keep you in office. You get people that run against you, and you know, they gotta prove to you that they're a better candidate than you are, and that you're unworthy to continue to serve it another 4 years. And then you're mystified as to why they forget that they voted for you the first time and not the second time. But this teaches you to know who your friends are and who your loyal friends are. And this position taught me that. And I'll always remember that. I always used to joke with my colleagues, and maybe for you, Bill Harris, but I was the only Republican, if you didn't know who I was, on this council. So when I used to hear you, Bill, about the Tea Party and the Republicans, I thought they slept together, and then you made comments that you were glad to see me out of office here, and I thought, well, Jesus, I thought I was on his side here, but I guess not. But not that's a big deal here, because both parties piss me off anyway, so. But I'll still be around. I'm not going anywhere. And am I okay with it, as people ask? Yeah, I'm okay with it. There's life after politics, you know? I was 6 months in office when I retired, so I never really got to slow down, settle down. It was just from one job to another. And yeah, sometimes it could be thankless, but the people that really see what we do, they're very appreciative of it. And there's so many people to thank, but you know, we got a reception to go to, so I'll probably have to do this again, and I'll thank people over there. Probably a big thank you to my family, my wife. You know, after the final votes were counted, she came up to me and said, you know, I get you back. She says, I guess I didn't realize how much time you put into this. I probably put it about a good 35, 40 hours a week. At least, yeah, at least. So it was like, it was more than a full-time job. And 2 days after the election, we took off for a vacation. And we realized that I hadn't taken a vacation in 2 years. That's a lot of time not to take any time away with your family. And it's not going to happen anymore. Because I've always had a supportive wife, loving. She's always been there. And that's why we've been together for nearly 40 years and 34 years of marriage. And a wonderful family that's very supportive. But I thank everybody for your support. And you may see me back here in 4 years. Gloria mentioned to me, you know, Steve, I got defeated one term, and then I came back and ran again, and I won. That may happen, because I've had a lot of people encourage me to do so. But let's see what the next 4 years bring about. I may enjoy the retirement, finally, and we'll see what happens from there. But thank you for everybody.
Won't you be here at the podium a few times?
Oh, you don't want a retired cop up there, because you haven't seen my nasty side. You know, you've seen my comedic side, but I don't know if the mayor wants to see me pissed off here.
2 minutes.
We
know it. Okay. The 2 minutes is for future public comment. It is not for your comments this evening, nor is it for yours, Councilmember Barnes.
That's good, because I got my act together now.
Okay, good.
First of all, I wanted to tell you that I read my speech to my students today. I teach sixth grade, for those who don't know. Gail's going to make me cry. Ooh, I thought I had it together. Okay.
I can ask her to leave. She can... Would you remove? Yeah, because she can do this later at the reception.
Gail's been my dearest friend and my treasure through thick and thin. And I mean, that woman, and you probably said the same thing. I'm glad I got my wife back because she's unbelievable, unbelievable. Anyway, I was talking to my students today, and I read this speech to them, and I fell apart like 3 times. And they said, okay, Ms. Barnes, you know what you need to do? And they're giving me all this advice. And they said, you need to look out there and pretend like they all have their underwear on. So I'm not really doing that, but I just thought I'd mention that. They're 11 years old, you know, what can I say? Okay. I am going to read my speech, though, because I'm the epitome of organized and analytical and all of the above. I drive them crazy because I have notes everywhere. So I wrote it, so I apologize for reading it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to get through it. Involuntary retirement is a hard pill to swallow. However, once I got it down, I realized it didn't taste as badly as I thought it would. Reminiscing about the past 12 years will take a lifetime, since one-fifth of my life has been here at City Hall representing my constituents, and never once did I take my position for granted. Every single day I came to work after my full-time job teaching, I felt was an honor and a privilege. Everyone here working for the city works hard and without glory. And all of these things that you see up here, we didn't do it. All the employees did it, and I thank you for that. I mean, we're just the ones that say yay and nay, but you're the ones who did this, so thank you for that. We get the credit and you don't, and that's not fair. Each employee is dedicated, committed, and amazingly resilient. To all of the 600 plus people I call family, I want to thank you 1,000 times, and please know I will never forget you. I know you will continue serving the public without complaint with diminishing resources. That's what you do best. To the business community, nonprofits, boards, and commissions I've served, and they've been mentioned by Mayor Donahue, I hope you look back knowing that I have given my very best to accomplish all the goals and priorities that have been set. So much has transpired, and so much effort and work has come to fruition. To my family, Thanks for putting up with long, endless hours of coming home in the wee hours and often being preoccupied with